Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to Ghost Chat YouTube channel. Hello there guys, my name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to another Ghost Shell review. Now this is another Alton Towers attraction. It's a classic family ride. It's now known as the Get Set Go Treetop Adventure, and as you can see by the title, in the old McDonald's farmyard and storybook land, you had Squirrel Nutty. And in today's video, we're going to be sharing the history of the ride, the stats of the ride, and also share my thoughts on Squirrel Nutty, because I adored this ride as a kid, absolutely adored it, and I want to share my memories of Squirrel Nutty as well as my thoughts on the ride as well. So if you want to see what the ride looks like now, you can see pictures and videos all over the internet of Get Set Go Treetop Adventure, the CBeebies Land attraction, that is what it is now. But before we get started with all of that, make sure you like the video if you love this review, comment down below your thoughts and opinions, subscribe to Coast Child YouTube channel for more, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling theme park video. Also guys, you can check in the description down below where you, that's right you, can find links to the Discord server, Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, all there. And also you can submit your video ideas, so if you've got an idea for a review, a closed but not forgotten video, a next 5 years video, or even a prediction or discussion video. I've said I wanted to do more predictions for Six Flags Parks and discussion videos for worldwide theme parks, so if you want me to discuss some topics in its own video with this setup, or if you want me to do some prediction videos and predict where rides are going to get removed here and there, or brought in here and there, what ride types could get brought into theme parks, then get into the description down below, find the Google Forms link and click there, because it's all there. And for now guys, let's have a look exactly what in the world is going on with the Squirrel Nutty and why it was such a nutty adventure. So this was located in the Storybook Land area of the park, among the treetops of the Storybook Land. It lived the Squirrel Nutty, a friendly creature who sought adventure high over the residents and neighbouring Old MacDonald's farmyard. Now this was manufactured by Premier Rides, costing £1 million, which is brilliant for a monorail family ride, with a height of 4 metres, a duration of 4 minutes approximately, 2 capacity per car, opened back in 1996 and closed back in 2013 for its CBeebies Land refurbishment. This is one nutty adventure. Now the arrival of Squirrel Nutty back in 1996 brought a brand new fresh of life to the area in between the farmyard and Adventureland, introducing Storybook Land. Pretty simple that. This saw the introduction of bizarre trees shaped to accommodate the track of the ride, as well as a brand new centerpiece in the form of the bookworm. While the ride originally opened, each acorn contained a set of pedals which presented riders with the opportunity to increase the speed. However, as the years went by, the pedals were removed, and with the ride experience remaining the same until the re-theme with CBeebies Line coming into the park in 2014 to replace both the farmyard and Storybook Land. Squirrel Nutty took its last guest for a ride at the end of 2013, with the area being re-themed CBeebies Land in 2014. Although the actual ride system was maintained during the development, when the ride reopened as Get Set Go Treetop Adventure, new theming and vehicle shells have been added, with the ride now focusing on the CBeebies Bugbees. Squirrel Nutty was one nutty adventure, and I enjoyed it throughout my years as an enthusiast so far. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that is Squirrel Nutty's history, a very nutty history indeed. So yeah, my memories on this ride, I mean, now you can enjoy it as the Get Set Go Treetop Adventure with the CBeebies Land theming, which is incredible. But if you enjoyed the original, then you'll miss it as much as I did. I first did this ride way back in 2005, and wow. Wow, this was just an incredible experience. This was an incredible treetop adventure. You had the nutty cars. I remember the nutty cars all too well. You know, the car shapes were amazing. They were brilliant woodland theming. The person that did the theming, or the company that did the theming for the cars, along with Premier Rides, you know, the people that did the theming with it, did a very good job with the theming of it. You know, it was very, very nice. All lovely and presented. I think that when years sort of went by, and it's sort of the last couple of years of its life, I think it's sort of, I wanted to wish for it to get refurbished in some way. I wasn't for one second thinking it was going to get completely ripped out for a CBeebies Land theme. However, you know, I was kind of hoping they did like a major overhaul of the ride, give it a proper family storyline, put some more theming into it, maybe give it a more detailed queue line, you know, just little overhauls here and there. I wasn't expecting the massive CBeebies Land refurbishment. However, looking back since 2014 with CBeebies Land, I think that it was the right move at the right time for both the farmyard and Storybook Land. I think the Squirrel Nutty being part of the development was very interesting. It helped bridge the gap between the farmyard and the storybook and bring it together rather than keep it apart. Cuckoo Cars Driving School at the Cloud Cuckoo Land, which is like a little one ride section now. It's barely an area. You know, you should just include that with Fountain Square, but now with Hex. But yeah, the Cuckoo Cars Driving School, you look at what that is now, that's in its own area rather than be part of the World David Williams. I think that'll change in a year or two. I think that'll be, you know, part of the World David Williams, like a phase two kind of thing. But you look at that's in its solo area now, near the back of Hex. And, you know, I was kind of thinking, if CBeebies Land was just going to be the farmyard, and it wasn't going to be Storybook Land as well, and imagine Squirrel Nutty in its, and the Bookworm, shall we say, as well, in its own area. And it would feel quite standalone, and it would feel quite, you know, isolated, in terms of standing out for the wrong reasons. So I think that including Storybook Land within the development of CBeebies would have been the right thing to do anyway. So, you know, I think its time had come. It was needed for a major overhaul. They couldn't do much to the Scrum storyline, even though I'd have liked it to happen. But they sort of brought in the CBeebies Land stuff, and, you know, for the kids, all hell broke loose in 2014 when CBeebies Land was packed day in, day out. So yeah, Squirrel Nutty was a one nutty adventure, as I keep saying in this video. It's got more nuts than Scrat, you know, and he loves nuts from Ice Age. But Squirrel Nutty was an incredible ride, brilliant children's ride, brilliant family ride. I loved it as a kid. Growing up as well, I still have recollect those childhood memories on the Squirrel Nutty attraction. And, you know, peeping over the top of the farmyard and, of course, the rest of Storybook Land, trying the bookworm, you know, pressing the button, seeing what it says and hearing what the bookworm says as well. So, yeah, Squirrel Nutty was overall an amazing, amazing experience. And, you know, like I say, it was the right refurbishment at the right time. You know, I think that's the way they could have gone with this. So, you know, overall, Squirrel Nutty was, I'll say it again, one nutty ride. But there we go, guys. Thank you very, very much for watching this Coast Show review on Squirrel Nutty at the Alton Towers Resort. We will be reviewing past attractions at Alton Towers, not just the present ones. Even though past attractions can still go in the closed but not forgotten section of the channel, it can also be reviewed if I've experienced them. You look at what we did with Corkscrew. That is a closed but not forgotten episode, and I believe it's also a review as well. So we've done both with past attractions, so there will be more past attractions that we will review, things like the Riverbank I Spy, the Tractor Ride. We've done reviews of the Flume as well. We've done that, so, you know, Riverbank I Spy and you know, the Tractor Ride, they'll still be coming as well. Current attractions like the Enterprise and the Blade, they're still to come as well. Other theme parks getting reviews as well, they're on its way. And if you've got any discussion video ideas or debating ideas or prediction video ideas, get the Google Forms link in the description down below. Get your video ideas in, because I want to do more discussion videos heading into the summer. But thank you very much, guys, for watching this review. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And for now, guys, my name is Coast Shell. Keep them the coast alive. And I'll see you guys next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a nutty-tastic day. Ooh.